Avation is a main listed company in London, and it's involved in the leasing of aircraft, operating in all over the world, basically. But it's perhaps an undiscovered gem in the sector. Very impressive annual growth, 30%, predicting 40% for next year as well. Its profitability after tax is approaching 25%, and it's well, doing pretty well in a challenging market. Well, we're joined now by the finance director of Avation, Richard Wolanski. Your growth rate is quite impressive. I mean, you've trebled in size in about as many years. How are you managing to keep this pace of growth up?
Well, it's a very large industry. I mean, our business model is quite simple. We own commercial passenger aircraft and we lease them over the long term to airlines. Now, the industry is growing at an extremely rapid rate. Historically, it's about global, double global GDP.
Yeah, but so are you actually growing at more than the industry in general?
Yeah, absolutely. We have a niche in the industry. We focus on narrow body aircraft. That is planes with two engine, one aisle, the most common planes that are flown today. We have a further specialisation in an ATR 72 turboprop, which is a 72 seat regional aircraft. And those planes are extremely popular, sold out for about 3.5 years. And so we've got huge demand for that aircraft.
Yeah, and also you're looking at buying some new jets as well, aren't you?
Yeah, that's right. A couple of months ago, we announced a new transaction with Thomas Cook, where we're going to be supplying them with two brand new jets, A321 jets, within 12 months' time.
Now, the whole notion of leasing aircraft is nothing new.
Yeah.
But you are doing better than the industry in terms of delivering growth. How are you doing that? Is that because of the way that you manage the risk of these leases? Is it the fact that you're getting the most out of the lease? You know, what is the difference that you're doing that makes a difference?
Our business has evolved quite rapidly over the last couple of years. We started specialising in the ATR 72 aircraft about 3 years ago, and we've evolved the business from just supplying that aircraft into Australia now to where we supply 6 or 7 of them per year globally. On top of that, we're expanding into the jet space, and right now where we sit today we have 29 aircraft, and so that 40% growth that you mentioned is actually about the supply of 4 or 5 ATRs over the next 12 months plus the 2 A321s to Thomas Cook.
Yeah. So it's the length of the lease is quite important, though, isn't it?
Yeah. It's one of our focuses on in terms of our business model is supplying brand new aircraft on long leases with the airlines, and by long leases I mean 10 to 12 years.
Yeah. So what advantage does that give you? I mean, you might think, well, if it's a long lease, that could be riskier.
No, it isn't from our perspective. What we like to do is we. Over that term, we like to fix our lease rates, and so the airline has a lot of certainty. Airlines do like to use assets for the long term. And what we do on the other side of that, when we borrow money to buy that aircraft, we're a leveraged company, we fix the interest rates, and so we actually eliminate risk over the long term by focusing on long-term leases.
Mm. I suppose the two big risks for your industry could be that an airline goes bust, and you know, the airlines that you thought would never go bust, but they have done.
Correct.
In recent years. And the fact, as you point out, that you are very highly leveraged. Now, that's sure. in a relatively low interest rate environment, there's no guarantee that's going to remain so.
Yeah, well, in terms of the first instance, the way that we deal with the risk in terms of airlines going bust is we obviously perform in-depth credit checks on the airlines that we deal with. We try to choose the best airlines to deal with. Because we deal in very popular aircraft that are in high demand, we can pick and choose our airlines to a certain extent. And the other thing about dealing with extremely popular aircraft is that if there ever is a default and you need to repossess an aircraft, the easiest plane to place with another airline is an aircraft that every other airline uses. In terms of the leverage that we have in the company, part of our philosophy and part of our business model about long-term leases is that we amortise the debt that we use to buy the aircraft over the term of that first lease. And so after the term of the first lease, 10 to 12 years, typically we'll own the aircraft outright, even though aircraft have, in general, an economic life of 25 to 30 years. So less than halfway through the aircraft's life, we'll own it outright.
Mm. Which is good, because then it's got still got some working life at the end to pass on to the next one.
Actually, and no debt, and no debt payments after that point in time.
Yeah. So you've got fairly ambitious growth plans. I mean, you've got 13 new aircraft due by the end of 2016. You've got 29 at the moment, so that's pretty impressive.
Very strong.
And you've got 22 further options for deliveries going forward. Isn't there a risk that you might be overstretching yourself?
No, not at all, because the way that the business model works, when you do amortise, because the 29 planes in our fleet today are all amortising their debt, our leverage on a month-by-month basis is actually going down. When we take on a new aircraft, that pushes the leverage back up. So we're able to manage our growth, one, by paying down the debt on existing aircraft, but also leveraging off planes that we've paid off, refinancing and releasing cash from the balance sheet and using that to fund our growth. We've been doing that very successfully. Our growth rates over the last 3 or 4 years are 30%+. So we've been managing that process very successfully.
Mm. So in terms of geography, are you changing the way that you look at the markets? Are you moving out of some markets into others? Where do you see the growth coming from going forward?
Well, if you look at the analysis of the aviation industry, it's the Asia-Pacific region which is leading the planet in terms of growth. We're well placed for that marketplace. We're domiciled in Singapore. Six of the last seven planes that we've delivered brand new have been into the Asia-Pacific region. We also really like the European sector as well. We just announced a deal for four brand new aircraft to be delivered to Flybe over the next 12 months as well. So those two key areas are very strong areas and a focus for us.
All right. Okay. Richard Wolanski, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you.